Let me tell you a very interesting story. But before that, let me just unfold my yellow table. The cooking journey for me, become a chef, everything all started in the home kitchen. Every Sunday, my father would cook up something or the other for me. Papa would explain all the small little nuances which are very, very important to cook a very great meal. Whatever that I cook today is dedicated to my father. Welcome to my yellow table. So, moving on to today's menu, it's pretty clear, it's Indian style minestrone. Now, minestrone is a very typical classic Italian soup. Essentially, it's a light tomato broth with a lot of vegetables and you just allow them to cook all together and it comes out beautiful. We are doing chicken tikka croquet with mint mayo. Chicken tikka is typical Punjabi dish, whereas a croquet is a French dish, which is basically mashed potatoes that you then coat it with breadcrumbs and deep fry. Mirchi palak kadhi, and we're going to do some fantastic olive paratha. That sounds interesting, yes? Let's get cracking. Alright, first up is Indian style minestrone. I've just added few Indian vegetables and few Indian spices to make it a little more Indianized version. So, first up, we're gonna just chop some onions. Alright, we've got the potatoes. In a minestrone, you can pretty much add whatever vegetable that you like. All you need to do is just take a bread, soak it in and eat. Similarly, we're gonna do this with zucchini. Just top and tail the zucchini. Nice, big, chunky dices. Keeping them nice and chunky is because these are vegetables at the end of the day, and when you cook them over and over again in a soup, they kind of mash away. So the thicker they are, the better they stay. Dice the carrots now. Last but not the least are the tomatoes. Remember again that this minestrone is a tomato based light tomato broth with a lot of vegetables. So tomatoes needs to be good in quantity. Celery, nice and fresh, gives that nice pungent flavor to the soup. Just dice it thick. Beautiful. Now we're just gonna fire. We don't have to brown the onions or the garlic, but we just need to sweat them. Alright, this is it. That's called sweating. It's like hardly cooking. And that's when we add the vegetables. All of them. Wow, good smell of onion, garlic and some great olive oil. What a combination. Now, I'm gonna add in the chopped tomatoes. Now I'm gonna add some basil. Some salt. Add Kia Malabar black pepper. Kerala's stable Malabar coast has been producing some of the world's best peppercorns for centuries. Organic peppercorns are picked out just before they ripen, sun-dried to perfection and steamed to preserve the penetrating pungent oil. Kia Malabar black pepper is handpicked specially from this Malabar region. Now we're going to add some water and we put on the lid and allow it to boil, and then we're just going to simmer it for about 10 minutes and that's about it. Alright, up next is chicken tikka croquet. First just cut them into big chunks. I'm going to marinate them first in some ginger garlic paste. We're gonna add some salt and some lemon. This is essentially called the first marination. What it does is, it allows the salt, the lime to just permeate into the chicken, which makes it really, really tasty. Just give it a nice mix. There, Just keep it aside for about 10 minutes. Now we move on to the second part, which is the second marination for the chicken. We're going to take some mustard oil because the pungency of that mustard oil is the key to a great tasting chicken tikka. Good. Now I'm going to mix some red chili powder. Now you don't need to add that red color which usually a lot of people add to chicken tikka. You just need to mix the chili powder with the mustard oil first and then proceed with the marination. All of this. All right. Now, that's my tray. That's my marinade. That's my chicken. So I'm just going to dunk my chicken into the marinade. Like this. Easy. Just going to place it here. All right. This goes inside the oven. 180 degrees for about 15 minutes. Yes, yeah, 15 minutes. Now, let's see where our soup stands. Wow. Yes, nice chunky vegetables. A nice thin tomato broth. All right, this is good to go. Yes. And I'm just going to shave some parmesan on top. All right, I'm going to bake some basil. Just put it on top. Cover this beautiful soup. Take this onto my yellow table. Now I'm going to introduce you to a very, very special person, somebody who's very, very young and energetic and has done something fantastic for the society. And she also loves food, especially she wants to cook for her dad. Her name is Ishita Singhal. Please welcome her. Hi Ishita.
Hi Chef.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good, good, good. So why I tell that this girl is special? Because at a very, very young age, she is not just dreamt of, but actually achieved a lot. When I say achieved a lot, she has actually done so much for the others. So why don't you tell us about it?
Me and my friends have recently opened an NGO which is called the Fulfilling Dreams Foundation. What we do exactly is we make lots of food for poor people whom we think cannot afford food, and then we go distribute food to them.
Fantastic. So you are 20, right?
Yeah, I'm 20.
So a very profound thought at the age of 20. Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you so much for coming on to the show. Now, is there something that you would like to
actually
dedicate
to someone? My dad's 50th birthday.
Okay.
So I'm here to learn cooking for him because he will be the happiest person to see me cook. And I've tried cooking for him, but I end up doing blunders. So he eats all my horrible food. So on his birthday, I want him to eat some delicious food.
Fantastic, fantastic. Don't worry. I think my attempt is going to be to teach you something which is simple, but with a little bit of twist.
Perfect.
Perfect?
Yeah.
Alright, so up till now, let me just explain to you what we've done. We've done the minestrone, Indian style minestrone soup. We've put the chicken tikka inside the oven for the croquet. Now we're going to proceed, we're going to make a curry. Moving on with curry. Curry kisse banti hai?
Lassi se.
Lassi se? Aur usme kya jata hai? Lassi matlab meethi ya namkeen?
Nahi, namkeen. Namkeen, I guess.
Namkeen lassi na? I guess acha. Alright. So, you guessed the first ingredient right, lassi or yogurt. Or दही अगर पुरानी हो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर. इसके अंदर डालते हैं बेसन.
बेसन
और 5 बिग स्पूंस ऑफ बेसन. वुड यू मिक्स देम फॉर मी?
या श्योर, आई विल लव टू.
ओके, मिक्स. नाउ आई एम एडिंग सम सॉल्ट,
चिली पाउडर,
लिटिल बिट ऑफ धनिया पाउडर, जीरा पाउडर, हल्दी, लिटिल बिट ऑफ कसूरी मेथी. ये मेरी अपनी रेसिपी है. इसके अंदर हम थोड़ा सा ना अदरक और लहसुन का पेस्ट भी डालेंगे. ठीक है? Clearly you haven't entered the kitchen much.
No, I have not. I've had bad baking experiences. So.
What were those experiences? I'd like to hear.
Years back, I tried making a chocolate truffle cake. I think there was somewhere written that you have to melt the chocolate. And I don't remember ki hame egg ko tab dalna tha, jalti hui gas pe dalna tha, kab dalna tha. What I did was that the chocolate was getting cooked and maine egg aise hi dal diya aur wo omelette ban gaya. So I made a chocolate truffle omelette.
Sounds yuck.
That was my first disaster, so I don't enter kitchen now.
Don't worry, at any point of time, you need recipes, good ones, workable ones. Just log on to www.ndtvgoodtimes and look for my yellow table. Meri sari recipes wahan par.
I'll do that.
We'll fire the gas and just put it on this. And we'll just allow it to cook.
Cook, yeah.
Later on, हम लोग एक तड़का बनाएंगे एंड वी विल जस्ट ऐड द तड़का टू द करी. सिंपल. यू मेक दिस फॉर योर डैड, ही विल बी वेरी हैप्पी.
आई होप
सो. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द सेकंड डिश. टाडा. स्टार्ट. सो नाउ व्हाट आई एम गोना डू इज आई एम जस्ट गोना चॉप द चिकन टिक्का एज chunky or as fine as possible rather. So Ishita, can you mash potatoes?
I can.
How do you mash potatoes?
वो जो instrument होता है उससे.
Instrument? क्या नाम होता होगा उसका?
वो मुझे नहीं पता.
Potato masher तो नहीं उसका नाम?
हाँ वही
तो. ये रहा instrument. इस instrument से आप इनका कल्याण कर लीजिए please.
जी. पर ये बहुत hard है यार. Is it okay?
Looks good. You're doing right. Doing good. Done? That's it. Alright, you go take a short break because when you come back, we're gonna finish our curry and we're gonna move ahead and do the olive paratha. That's my favorite.